Philippine Coast Guard assets are deployed to Limay, Bataan to contain an oil spill from a sunken tanker. President Marcos Jr. ordered government agencies to prevent a potential environmental catastrophe. Jeff Caparaz reports.
President Marcos has ordered several government agencies to assess the environmental impact of the capsized oil tanker Terra Nova off the coastal town of Limay in Bataan.
Can we please add an instruction to the DNR to make already an assessment on the environmental impact of this? Basically, what we need to assess is where is the capsized vessel? The fuel that's being released, what are the tides, what are the winds, where is it headed?
We can also make some
determinations on that.
The country's environment chief has already visited Limay to extend aid and support the Coast Guard and local government.
Ang DNR ay nandito upang tumulong po sa mga efforts na ginagawa ng Philippine Coast Guard at ng local government. So our assets are at the disposal, no? Particularly yung meron po kami isang barko na pwedeng humanap kung saan man ang barko natin ngayon. So malocate man siya in order to support the work. So we can anticipate kung meron mang environmental impact itong paglubog.
The Philippine Coast Guard was alerted of the incident after receiving a distress call from the oil tanker Wednesday evening. Coast Guard ship BRP Melchora Aquino responded to the emergency and saved 16 out of 17 crew members.
Bandang mga alas 10 ng gabi, naramdaman na nila na malakas yung alon at nag-decide yung kapitan na bumalik. Pero initially, nahirapan sila sapagkat ang sabi nila ay pasalubong sila dun sa alon. At ang term ng mga crew ay sumalok sila ng alon at pinasok yung barko hanggang tuluyan sila nag-capsize.
The remains of the lone fatality were recovered Thursday afternoon. The victim's identity has not been made public. The distressed ship carrying 1.4 million liters of industrial fuel oil was heading to Iloilo when it capsized. Authorities were investigating if the accident was caused by Super Typhoon Carina, which dumped a huge amount of rainfall and caused flooding in Metro Manila and nearby provinces. An aerial survey conducted by PCG showed an oil slick extending up to 2 nautical miles from where the boat capsized.
Wala pang signs na tumatagas na at yun ang magiging goal natin na malaman kung tatagas based doon sa plan ng barko. Malalaman natin kung gaano ka secure yung water integrity ng mga tanks niya.
PCG spokesperson Rear Admiral Armand Balilo said that they have deployed their Marine Environmental Protection Team to contain the oil spill. Coast Guard personnel in Navotas, Bulacan, and Pampanga have also been tapped to monitor and prepare for a possibility of a bigger oil spill.
Malaki yung danger that Manila would be affected, even the shoreline of Manila pag nag-leak ng fuel, because it is within Manila Bay, no? And kasama yon sa contingency na pinaghahandaan natin kung sakaling abutin yung Manila. At that, you know, ang marine environment effect nito ay hindi magiging maganda.
Balilo adds, they might seek assistance from the private sector to recover oil containers from the half-submerged ship. The oil on board Mount Terra Nova is nearly double the amount compared to the 800,000 liters of oil from MT Princess Empress, which capsized in Mindoro last year.
Kung naalala nyo yung incident doon sa Mindoro, masyadong malalim at nag-succumb sa pressure yung mga tanki niya at talagang lumabas yung oil. Ito hindi naman masyadong malalim eh. Pinacheck ko nga kasi nung una, half submerged lang siya. Baka sakaling mababaw lang at we're hoping, no, na hindi maapektuhan yung water integrity ng mga tanks niya and hindi tumagas yung langis.
Fishermen are also advised to steer clear of the affected areas. Limay Vice Mayor Richie Jason David says they will conduct a joint investigation with the PCG and Department of Environment regarding the incident. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista said that they have coordinated with the private sector for the deployment of resources needed to retrieve the oil. The PCG has also deployed 244-meter multi-role response vessels for this initiative. The agency also raises the possibility of siphoning oil from the sunken tanker next week.
So it capsized at 1 o'clock early this morning.
and there is already oil spill, sir. And right now we cannot dispatch our resources because of strong winds and high waves. So, we already coordinated with the private sector, Harbor Star, and they will deploy the resources as soon as possible.
Officials say the owner of MT Terra Nova have also hired a salvor to salvage the ship. Jeff Caparaz, ABS-CBN News.